You Star Wars fans and collectors, this is Fly Guy for FlyGuy.net. Taking a look at this today, the Sideshow Collectibles Wolfpack Clone Trooper, the 104th Battalion. So this is a trooper that appeared literally like that in the Clone Wars. You saw this Phase 2 helmet so briefly and it was gone. So Sideshow basically taken that animated appearance from the Clone Wars and of course put it onto their kind of repeated typical like body that they've done many many times in this kind of style and version. So if you're new to Sideshow, there's a lot of clones out there. This is another one, a very good one as well. So we'll take a look at this in just a second. Let's get a quick look at the packaging on the front of the box. And we'll zoom in just a little bit to sharpen that up there for you. So there we go, Phase 2 helmet for this guy. There's the logo up at the top, 104th. Not much else on the box. This is a very slim and slender box for Sideshow. As you can see, there's the Disney logo. In fact, never seen that before in a Sideshow release, that I recall anyway. And there's the another preview of the figure there. Again, not a great deal going on. There's one in the back there just showing a jetpack that he's got. And the cool Wolfpack logo on his shoulder. This is a very weathered clone. There's a lot of work ongoing in this thing here. But it looks particularly good. Just a little bit of yada yada on the bottom there from Sideshow. And up at the top we got a Star Wars logo. Not much else going on. The inside container, got a window box to show you some of the remaining parts. And there's the Star Wars logo. No text explaining what's going on. Now all I've got left inside here is a basic Star Wars stand. That's a black Star Wars stand with the logo on it. You can just about see inside. There's really not much to show you in that. I'm going to show you the alternative stand a friend of mine got me. Now there are some spare hands that come with this figure. Basically you've got about six different hands. You've either got a kind of thumb up, a trigger hand, an open hand. Again, I'll show you the ones on the video. And if you've never seen a Sideshow review, there's tons of review in my channel here. You can go back and look it through these because they're all pretty standard. It also gets at what I call kind of clown feet, running feet for Sideshow figures. Basically the figure in a running pose. But they're really accessories. Again, I'm going to show you the figure and all the full details, so let's get on with that. So, as I mentioned, a good friend of mine managed to get hold of the other stand for me, the limited edition one, just as an extra, which was particularly nice. So thank you, good friend, you know who you are. And there we go, there is the stand that that comes with. As I mentioned, the other alternative one there just says Star Wars on a black background and Star Wars is in silver. But you get the 104th Battalion, the Wolfpack name and logo there. So there we go, we get a crotch stand where basically the figure sits on there and that's how the figure stands up. Now the figure also comes with, I really like this actually, a backpack which has came before with some other clones. You'll see some behind me over there which have yet to be reviewed, but we'll get round to them and you'll see them. So this backpack here is pretty damn cool. Very weathered looking, lots and lots of detail and carbon scoring on it. Lots of different marks, and it's been used before in Sideshow clones. It's got this nice kind of fabric on one side so it doesn't rub off in the figure, but this kind of plastic, nice kind of grip feel rubber on the front of it, so it's a pretty good looking piece overall. There's nothing inside it. You can take that little stud off there and have a look inside, and you could put some components in there, maybe some droid poppers from some of the previous figures. Sadly, there's nothing else to put inside this in here, so you could pack your lunch if you want, if you're a very small person, but it literally clips on to the front onto your little stud. Just trying to do that, I have no nails. There you go, and that's the little stud that it goes onto there. So you can have that alternative look of this backpack and a nice recessed piece inside here which allows the trooper's piece on his back to just sit smoothly inside there, or you can do as I've done and go with a jetpack. Now the jetpack is, again, being used before on Rex and others, magnetic. Very nice indeed. So magnets within this makes it a little heavy, but it feels good. And buried within here, there's obviously magnets as well. And it just almost attracts itself on, and that's you. So it stays on pretty well. Excellent piece the way it's done. And of course you get those little grips on the top there just to align it, just in case the magnets are off a little bit. But we get a beautiful looking piece here, very Django-esque. No kind of major details on here that you really need to see other than the weathering, that very even carbon scoring going across it, but it's beautifully done. Trooper just looks absolutely great with it. So again, we get to see these guys very briefly in the Clone Wars, and it's again a blink and it's gone situation, but they do look absolutely stunning. So looking forward to getting more Wolfpack clones. So the body itself, as all sideshow figures tend to be, is a super articulated body. Just in case no one knows what these sideshow figures are like, literally every joint is bendable. And we could talk about this all the kind of joins, but literally every join can be, as you can see, little pegs can pop off to swap the feet. Every join can be moved around on the figure. So you do get complete flexibility as that peg shows you. You can have a back and forth. It's basically a ball joint. If we take that off, you can see that moving on there. So every other joint, again, it's super articulated. So every pose you could possibly get with this guy. Now, the downside of that is it does make it a little bit, just a little bit sometimes, limbs can be a little bit loose, but this one's actually not too bad. In terms of the rest of the look of the figure, let's get a closer look at him, and you can get to see some of the detail, particularly on this helmet, which really is rocking. There's the Wolf Pack symbol, and it looks really good. And this is the real steal of this figure. It really is the Wolfpack logo. It just makes it look fantastic. I also do a podcast, try and be there normally at least once every week with the guys on the Wolfpack podcast. And they're huge fans of the Wolfpack too. Dave Filoni and all the clones as well. So if you don't know about them, check them out. So really, again, this is one, if you've bought other Sideshow clones before, this will be another one for you, having clonitis like myself. But otherwise, it's really just another repaint of a figure there from Sideshow. Again and again, it's the same kind of thing they tend to do. As I turn my phone off. And so nothing is really different. There's no difference on the armor that we've seen before. It's basically just paint. So you're getting this gray color scheme running throughout the figure, all down the knees. But what does make it that little bit different is the weathering. Sideshow have really kind of came up in terms of the weathering. It's just getting much, much better. It used to be the odd splodge of not that great looking black paint, but this one is particularly nice. I love that backpack there, that back piece with all those little controls and buttons and dials on there. It looks very cool indeed. But really the steal is this helmet. It's all about this difference in the face and the sculpt and the paint. And again, we've had a few Phase 2 clone troopers, but again, just adding that colouring, adding that weathering, and you get a different clone. Nice little touch of silver paint on the front mouthpiece there. Other than that, there's not a great deal else to show you. The weapon is one of these more modern versions of Sideshow's guns that they've done, which has the kind of dart piece at the front, or the firing kind of rocket missile that we've seen basically clones scale walls and so forth with. It is beautifully done again with the silver wash across the blaster. Gorgeously done. The gun is absolutely huge. It's ginormous. But it does seem to be into scale with the figure. But this is a beautifully done weapon. And does not surprise me that they just keep repeating and repeating this blaster here overall, or this rifle. Now there is another rifle in the pack. I should have actually got that out. Let me just get that out here for you. In fact, you can see it on the front cover. We've reviewed these many, many times before. Standard lock stock pistol for these. So there's basically that inside the box, as well as this big guy here. I won't take up too much more time in this review because we've already gone on long enough. So that's the blaster. The rest of the figure, well, in terms of articulation, you can see him. He will move his head pretty much any way you want to. On the sides and the arms, back, forth, round, elbows, joins, spinning around and holding these weapons pretty well. Again, just about every way you could think of articulation. The waist's a little bit tough because of the basically the kind of equipment that he's got around his waist, but you can get, there you go, if you lift it up, you can get some articulation going on there. Same for the legs, thighs, and again, we showed you down the bottom with the swappable feet, you can get some good poses on there. The only downside, yet again, it's a standard thing that's been going on for years with Sideshow clones, is the body armor they have underneath is a very shiny fabric, and the armor can sometimes slip down, meaning you've got a very weird looking kind of clone there with basically it's almost like his knickers are on the floor or something. It's kind of falling down, and just it just doesn't look great. So I wish they would have put some kind of Velcro or something in there to stop that, but I guess it's problematic or hard to do, I don't know. But it doesn't seem to affect much else on the figure apart from these thigh pieces. They're always pretty problematic. But if you get it posed and you get it in the right way, they'll stay, and it'll stay pretty good. That's it. A very quick overview of the Wolfpack 104th Battalion clone. We talk about all this stuff, Star Wars and other reviews, on the Realm Recap, a show I do weekly with YakFace.com, where we talk about Sideshow quite a bit. Definitely check it out. You can subscribe here or on the YakFace channel. Either way, you still get the same show. We bring it to you on both channels. That's it. Love to know your thoughts on the Sideshow clone, the 104th Battalion. Is it one you'll buy? Is it one you'll skip? Is it just another repaint you just don't want? Love to hear your thoughts. Please do leave a note under the comments. I'll generally get back to everybody and reply as soon as I can. So give it a chance and I will get back to you. So we'll have a little conversation about this clone. Tell us what you think and we'll see you for more Star Wars reviews coming up soon.